Oh, thanks.
This really is a lovely place, Auntie.
Not bad, I suppose. You should have let me know you were coming.
Oh, well, I sort of left in a hurry. I had a huge row with Daddy again, and I walked out.
Does he know you're here?
No, not yet. I had to get out, Auntie Joan. I couldn't do a thing and he'd be shouting at me.
Just like Father. Ted always was his favourite. Must have rubbed off, I suppose. Still, you're going to have to let him know you're here.
Oh, I will. But I wanted to get myself set up properly down here first. You know, get a job and somewhere respectable to live. Then Dad won't have any reason to drag me back.
What sort of a job do you have in mind?
Well, I thought I might try and break into modelling.
Isn't that just a young girl's pipe dream?
Well, I did a course in Brisbane and the instructor said I had great potential. Oh, well, of course, I'm not definitely set on the idea, but I thought I'd give it a try and try and find some other work to keep me going in the meantime.
You got any money?
Not much.
Well, how did you intend to survive until you got a job?
Well, I hoped you might be able to help me out. Well, just for a little while, I mean.
Oh, now, look, a prison officer's wage doesn't go that far.
Oh, I didn't mean with money. I can get the doll. But I thought if you'd let me stay here with you just for a little while...
No, I don't think
so.
Well,
I wouldn't get in the way, I promise. I could even help. You know, do the housework, cook, that sort of thing.
No, I couldn't expect you to do that.
Please, Auntie Joan. And Dad probably wouldn't kick up such a fuss if he knew I was staying with one of the family.
I wouldn't be so sure of that.
Could we give it a go, just for a little while?
All right, we'll see how we go.
Oh, thanks, Auntie Joan.
Look, there's no need to get carried away. Good night. Come on, Major. Bedtime.
Good night, Major.